Hello, my name is Fern Axelson, and I'm here to show you through the process of vertebrate collections and their uses in research, education, and conservation purposes. Let's go. Here is the start of vertebrate specimens, a bioprep lab. Here, volunteers and staff dissect various specimens which die naturally. These animals primarily come from wildlife rehab centers and all are used for biological study. When dissecting specimens, the preparators are responsible for taking measurements of the animal and samples of endo- and ectoparasites, such as the lice seen here, for a growing research base. Samples of the muscles, the liver, heart, and kidneys are also taken for DNA studies. This can help future researchers determine biological health of a species in set areas over time. After this data and the preparation of the specimen is collected, the bones come here to a dermisterium. Dermestids are a common flesh-eating beetle and the most efficient method for cleaning bones for collections. Pelts of specimens are kept for research as well, documenting coloration and fur patterns, morphological studies, and sometimes for DNA use. Items are cataloged and put into collections from the lab. Researchers here can use all these specimens and the samples collected from them. While specimens are generally used for study, they can also be used as educational aids. Education collections allows for hands-on carts for public use. Smaller organizations, such as your local nature center, keep biological records and collections for education as well, teaching members of the local community about the wildlife near them. Conservation relies on biological understanding of not just scientific researchers, but every person who interacts with an environment. Keeping specimens in collections like this can help accomplish just that.